An Ace garden sprayer for only $9.99 with Ace Reward Card. Pennzoil motor oil, only $2.99 a quart. Ace All Seasons water hose, 5/8 inch by 50 foot, kink resistant and reinforced for only $9.99 with Ace Reward Card. From a doghouse to your dream home, get all your building supply needs at Harris Ace Hardware, West Cherry Street in Jessup.
Time now for a look, ladies and local sports. We'll begin with March Madness. This last night, Loyola Chicago beats Nevada 69-68. Michigan over Texas A&M 99-72. Kansas State knocks out Kentucky 61-58. And Florida State knocks out Gonzaga 75-60. Saturday, Loyola Chicago will play Kansas State and FSU will play Michigan. Those winners Saturday head to the Final Four. Four more games tonight. Final Four will be set by Sunday evening. Four games this evening, Clemson against Kansas, West Virginia against Villanova, Syracuse against Duke, and Texas Tech against Purdue. Again, they'll have the Final Four set for Sunday night, and again, they'll all head to San Antonio, Texas for the championship game the following weekend. Wayne County Varsity Baseball team headed to Guyton today for the third game of a three-game set with South Effingham, but the Jackets have already won the series as they've taken the first two games with a 10-0 win at South Effingham on Wednesday. Then last night, the Bow defeated the Mustangs in a come-from-behind win. Final score 9-4. Junior James Mollin comes in relief in the third inning, pitches a two-hit baseball, allows no runs, strikes out 8. Mustang batters in picking up the win on the mound. Four times in the hot bat, 4-for-4, including a double. Griffin Boykin went 2-for-3 with a double that sparked a 4-run fourth, which brought the Jackets back from a 4-1 deficit to a 5-4 lead. Then the Jackets added the insurance runs in the sixth. Griffin Boykin with a 2-run single in that sixth as the Jackets scored 4 runs to win it by a final of 9-4. After the win, we talked with head coach Justin McDonald.
This was a lot tougher game than the one down in Guyton, but down 4-1, James comes on the mound and just starts shutting down the Mustangs. The team rallies. Griffin gets the big double to jumpstart the inning. 4-4 for 4. Some good base running, good defense. Another some other good plays. Again, it's short by Cooper. Griffin gets that line drive. But talk about that catch in foul territory by Cade Lambert. First of all, how far he came.
Yeah.
Then just reach out there and do a basket catch. That was phenomenal.
Yeah, he makes it look so easy. Like I said, we got some great guys out there in the outfield that can go get balls. And, well, that's a weapon that a lot of people don't look at when, you know, people look at who's on the mound and who's behind the plate, that type of stuff. But those guys that are playing in outfield right now, they can go get it. Those are three of our fastest guys on our team. So, like I said, they're out there for a reason because they're great players. And, again, it don't really amaze me to see him make them plays. We watch him run down balls in BP every day, and it's something to watch. But he's a special player.
We talk about all the arms we got. Yeah. Were you surprised at how well James pitched in relief? I mean, did that surprise you?
No.
Have you seen that in tryouts? I mean, workouts?
Well, he's got good stuff. It was no surprise. And, you know, he's one of those that he's comfortable coming in off a position and not really having to go into the pen. And because, you know, he makes a lot of throws in between innings. And I know he communicated that with Coach Mullis and Coach Browning, and that he felt comfortable coming in and just getting 8 warm-up pitches and towing it up. So, like I said, he's a competitor, and he plays the game the right way. I wouldn't say it was a surprise, but – like I said, that's exactly what I expected him to do. And, again, I'm proud of him for what he did. This is a team game. You know, Doubley struggled a little bit. I know that one inning, I think they had a couple of weak hits that somehow found a hole. But, again, he'll come back. He's a great senior. He's been pitching well all year. So, like I said, the thing about our team right now is their demeanor is kind of flatlined. We talked before a game, some kind of adversity is going to hit this game, and it hit us there when they score 4, and we just kept that flat line, didn't go down and didn't go up, but kept the flat line and found a way to win it.
Well, we won the series. Now we look for the sweep. Yeah. But, again, just a great come-from-behind win. The team's shown that time and time again. Yeah. It doesn't matter if they get down, they can come back. How important is that to be able to show that this early in the season?
That's very important. I know we talk a bunch about how many outs you got left in a game, and when you got 2 outs left in the end, there's still 33% chance, or 33% of that inning left, and that's the mentality they have. They have it with 2 strikes, there's still 33% of the strikes left. So, like I said, that's their mentality. I know when we went down, they look at how many outs we got left to get those runs. And like I said, you just kind of sit back and wait, and somebody will spark us tonight. It was Griffin, and he sparked it with a double, and then they kind of roll with it. But like I said, it's somebody different every time. If you go back, look, we were down, it's somebody different that sparks it, and that's a sign of a great team with great players.
Great win. Congrats on the win, Coach. We'll see you tomorrow night again. Look for the sweep.
Yeah, sounds good. You know, it's tough to beat somebody 3 times, but again, we'll go give our best and then see what happens. Like I said, our region's wide open, and again, you saw it is Wayne County versus South Effingham, so anything can happen. We just got to play.
And once again, that game today in Guyton, Georgia, 6 p.m. Our pregame today on Big Dog Country at 5:50. Revised JV schedules out. JV team back in action Tuesday at St. Mary's. They play Camden County Tuesday at 5 p.m. The middle school conference finals are underway, or semifinals. Again, the tournament's underway. Semifinals and finals set for this Saturday over in Baxley. Both Martha Puckett baseball and North Williams baseball teams are in the semifinals at 10 a.m. Martha Puckett will play Appling County in Baxley. Then at 12 noon is Arthur Williams against Pierce County. Then the two winners play for the championship game that afternoon. Wish both Martha Puckett and Arthur Williams the best of luck in that conference tournament over in Baxley this Saturday. Soccer teams host to Ware County here Thursday. Varsity girls win 1-0. Jay Drawdy, the lone goal for Wayne County. Boys win 5-3 in a shootout as it was tied 2-2. Head to the shootout. The goals in regulation by Alex Browning and Abraham Morales, a freshman. In the shootout, goals by Matthew Vanderveen, Alex Browning, and Christian Garcia. And Wayne County boys win the shootout and win 5-3. Varsity tennis versus South Effingham. Boys win 4-1. Girls lost 1-4. Kelly Popple wins the girls event in straight sets 6-1, 6-1. Boys winners Aiden Howard in straight sets. Austin Brown 6-3, 6-1. Doubles teams win. And, again, our congratulations to tennis boys as they win that match yesterday. Track and field meet at Ware County. Kevonte Nix wins the 400-meter dash. Delmar Smith wins the 300 to 110 hurdles. Trevin Wallace wins the long jump. Finn Ogden the pole vault. Arabi Easley the 100-meter hurdles. Bryce Hadlock wins the 800-meter. Boys 4x100 team consisting of Delmar Smith, Jayshawn Curran, Bryce Hadlock, and Kevonte Nix all take first place. Middle school golf. Arthur Williams 193, Martha Puckett 293, Ware Middle 279. Girls event, Ware Middle 110, Arthur Williams 129, Martha Puckett 140. Played at Okie Finokie. Low medalist was Arthur Williams, Ashton Davis. He shot a 46. Finley Burke 47, Antonio Warbay 48, Judson Holly shot a 49. Martha Puckett, Cole Driggers 48, Tate Carter 55, Jack Trapnell 66, Ben Lott 70. Arthur Williams girls, Cresslin Carter 62, Jorney Jordan 67. Martha Puckett, Jameson Stevens, 67, Grace Williamson, 73. Conference tournament in golf for middle school set for March 27th. Some middle school track. Martha Williams competed in the track event, finished a close third. The Jackets that placed, or as follows, Quay Simmons first in the 100 and 200-meter races. He was third in the high jump. Tavares Wilkins first in the shot and third in both the high jump and 200 meters. Garrison Keith second in the 110 hurdles. Jose Valdez, Maurice Goodman, Demetrius McBride, and Noah Prince also contributed to the point total. The 4x100-meter relay team also finished in second place. That's going to do it for the latest in local sports. Again, Wayne County baseball today, game 3 against South Effingham from Guyton. We'll have it for you at 5:50 pregame, 6 o'clock first pitch here on Big Dog Country FM 105.5. Sports is brought to you each